I think they're crazy enough to consider using nuclear weapons on Iran. They haven't done it so far. I totally disagree with those who say that there were nuclear devices set up in Yemen, in Lebanon. I mean, I know some people say that. I think it's nonsense. But it is true that during Desert Shield, when the 82nd was sent to Saudi Arabia, I think it was Cheney who was asked, well, what happens if the Iraqi armored corps cross the border and attack? I mean, that's still a very weak force compared. It's infantry, essentially. And he said, well, the first line of defense would be obviously the carriers and the tactical aviation on carriers. But secondly, he said, you know, and we looked, the option was to use nukes. I think they consider that. We know that U.S. considered that in the past, also during the Korean War.
Right.
I think if they really get hurt, they actually might start using tactical nukes. I wouldn't put it past them. They're crazy enough for that.
But if you're Russia and you see them use tactical nukes, what's your response?
You do whatever. Your response has to be, first of all, political, as strong as you can, because there is a huge political price that you can extract from the empire for doing so. I mean, the world opinion is going to just explode in outrage.
Right.
But secondly, militarily, you try to stay out of it. You do not want to be involved with a nuclear power that's gone crazy.
Right.
So I think all Russia can do is, of course, I mean, anything that looks like a real war in the Middle East would happen the same thing that happened the first time around, which is the Russian military would go on full alert, would be ready for any contingency. But I don't think they're going to enter a direct shooting war with the U.S. because that would expose Russia to a crazy nuclear power. That's not what Putin has been elected to do.